We are launching our tree injection program. Our insect control staff are going to be injecting approximately 1,000 ash trees, green ash trees, on boulevards and in parks to protect them from emerald ash borer. That's one piece of the strategy to respond to the find of emerald ash borer.
We're going to be predominantly in the Archwood area and then moving about 5 kilometers from there, because that is considered the epicenter. That's where the emerald ash borer was found. Once we inject it, about a week's period of time, it'll be throughout the entire tree. It helps to minimize the adults from laying eggs and also to kill the larva.
Other pieces of the strategy are to remove or cull out the trees that we will not be injecting. And we will be removing about 800 trees this year. It's difficult to remove a tree that still looks okay, that appears to be in good condition, but at the same time, costs can also be reduced by removing those trees at a time before they become dangerous. So when a tree is infested with emerald ash borer and dies from EAB, it becomes dangerous because the structural integrity of the tree is significantly affected. So branches start falling, major limbs start falling, the tree actually can fall over, particularly within 2 years of it being killed from emerald ash borer. So we are also very mindful and responsible for protecting the safety of the public.
We have a gray dot, which means it's a candidate for the injection. And when you see a purple dot, that means the tree is going to be removed.
If we choose to do nothing, there would be thousands and thousands of removals required. Potentially could be up to 15 to 20,000 removals in 1 year, which logistically is just not feasible. That's why it's important for us to be more proactive and start this program sooner, so that we aren't strapped with those thousands of removals, because it also is a risk to public safety.